Here's the data that we're working with in this exercise. The large table is what you should have downloaded, and the two columns of figures on the right are the means for figure 3 and for figure 2a. We're going to draw a column chart to compare two groups of numbers. Basically, we will be comparing the results at the beginning of the experiment and at the end of the experiment under two conditions. You can see that the two statistics for the first period and the two for the final period are in bold here. Select these cells by clicking on them while holding down a control key, or if you're a Mac user, hold down a command key. And then you click Insert, look for the chart icon, and click on the first 2D column option. Excel is going to offer you all sorts of options for fancy 3D columns. They look pretty, but they can make it harder to see the relative heights of the columns. So it's good practice always to stick to two dimensions when displaying data, unless you really, really need to use a 3D chart. We want to see the change between period 1 and period 10, so that needs to be on the horizontal axis. To do this, you need to right-click on the chart, that's a control click if you're on a Mac, and click Select Data. Then a box comes up. This is what it looks like in Windows. Mac users, just hang on for a second because the box you will see looks a bit different. The big button swaps the axes. With this box opened, then select Series 1 and Edit. Series 1 represents the experiment done without punishment, and we want to tell people that. So type this into the box as the series name and click OK. Do this for the other series, which is with punishment. Next, we want to label the two groups of bars. One shows the result in period 1, and the other is for period 10. So click on the right-hand side box on entry 1 and on edit. We could just type 1 and 10. We're going to pick up these names direct from the spreadsheet. This is always good practice, because if you edit the spreadsheet, the chart will automatically synchronize and pick up any new data. Click on cell A3, comma, and on A12, which are the two rows we need. This selects A3 for the name of the first group and A12 for the name of the second group. Click to exit the box, and as you can see, they previously said 1 and 2, and now they say 1 and 10, which is correct. This refers to the periods of the experiment. Now, Windows users, you can relax, and we'll watch the same thing done on a Mac. On a Mac, the switch row and column button is in a different place. Editing the labels is similar. And the process of picking up the labels from cells A3 and A12 is pretty much the same. Select one, comma, select the other. And the output is the same. So, moving on, back in Windows, at the top of each bar, we want to display the data that the height of the bar represents. So, you right-click, Mac users, you would control-click in the same situation, on one of the columns, click Add Data Labels. For Mac users, this just adds the number automatically. Windows users have an alternative to add callouts, which puts the number in a fancy little box with an arrow. But just as we picked a 2D chart, often the easiest chart for other people to understand is the simplest one. And in this case, that means we simply add the number above the bar. So click Add Data Labels to do this. Finally, as always, label your axes clearly and add a chart title. Now, it's easy to compare the outcome in period 1 and in period 10 without punishment and with punishment.